plays games with Jay.
Because...
Why?
Oh, wait. Ladder can't be moved? No, that's not it. Never mind.
Wait, what did you say?
Ladder couldn't have been used like that in the crime because there was no time. The ladder does reach the... Oh, wait. Does it? Right. Okay. The only reason the ladder reached the window was because it was on the stage. If you used the ladder on the poolside, it would not quite make it. The ladder could barely reach the window when it was on the stage. Oh, wait, what?
Is he saying again?
Okay. And there's nothing on the poolside of the gym as tall as the stage. Finally, the ladder was found in the gym, correct? If the culprit used the ladder on the poolside, we wouldn't have found it in the gym. And they couldn't have thrown a ladder back through the window because it's too heavy.
Then Gonta used his cool strength to throw the ladder or the body or something.
Gentlemen, not throw dead bodies or ladders. Also, watch language. The body could not have been thrown into the piranha tank to begin with. It would need to be placed carefully to prevent the glass pane from shifting.
Got it, muscle lad? Even if we injected tons of steroids into you, it'd be impossible.
Sorry, you're right.
You didn't need to apologize, Gonta.
I will try harder. Gonta will.
How the culprit moved the body from the window. You guys don't even know that? What a bunch of dimwits!
Do you have the answer, then?
But of course. Tell him, Shuichi! Blow him all away with the truth!
Kaito, wait, what?
Blow him all away! He knows-
I actually don't know that yet.
Fuck! What?!
The culprit definitely moved the body through the window, but I don't know how.
Seriously?
Serves you right. You just made a fool out of yourself after acting all high and mighty.
Dude, they just need to shut up and take their licks. What are we gonna do, Shuichi? We gotta figure this out. We're gonna take our licks.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't know. Take your punches. Or
oh,
like,
your beatings.
Hey, okay. You gotta do something, Shuichi. Come on.
I know. I have to do something, but I don't know what to do. I haven't figured that out yet. Damn it. Am I really not good enough? Am I no good as a detective? I can't do this. I can't. I don't think it really matters how the body got into the piranha tank. What? Gonta thinks it matter. We won't know our culprit's trick unless we figure out... We're getting sidetracked. It doesn't matter how it was done, just who did it. We shouldn't focus on where we found the body. Instead, we need to focus on where he was killed. Where he was killed? Wouldn't it be more efficient if we focused on the murder scene instead? Yes, that's it. We were so caught up in where the body was found, when we should have been thinking about where the murder occurred.
And the murder.
The murder. The body was found. The body. The murder
scene would definitely have more clues about the culprit. Why didn't anyone realize this yet? That's strange.
Perhaps the culprit steered the conversation away from that topic.
Then... culprit is someone in this room?
Yes, Gonta. Yeah. That's why we're here.
Wait, did someone die? Where is Ryoma? Guys, no one asking important question. Where is King?
Where is King?
Also, Rantaro.
Yeah, Rantaro and Kaede.
And Kaede, where did they go? Oh, Gonta.
Yeah. Wait. Weren't there 5 monocops?
That's important to remember. It's not as if everyone here wants us to find the truth. One of us is trying to sabotage this trial. Well then, let's discuss the crime scene to figure out who the culprit is.
That's not a bad idea for a robot. The last time I heard such a good idea was... when Nino told me to move in with her under the bridge to get out of the cold.
Himikawa under the bridge?
If we can determine where this all started, we can determine how it ended.
I think, wasn't that the opening we missed? Arakawa under the bridge?
Probably.
Yeah. Watch our anime
opening challenge videos on my channel. I win every time.
Fuck off. Yes, it's much too soon to quit. The trial has only just begun. Thank you, Maki. That was a helpful insight. And after this, we really should just get to know each other better.
No.
I can't believe you didn't notice that. I guess that's why you're still an apprentice. First, let's establish the crime scene. Was it a dorm room? Ryoma was relaxing in his room when he got attacked. But the cause of death was drowning. There's nothing in his room that would collect enough water.
He's got a toilet, doesn't he?
Drown in a toilet? Impossible! We should consider places where water is stored.
The only place that fits is the pool. Even if you used magic, there's no other way.
Well, it must be the pool then. Nah, a little turd drowned in the toilet. Shut your mouth, you noisy sow. Sow.
Oh my. What is... It's a good thing Miyu's never met the ultimate cat. Let's see. Okay, drown in water. Okay. Pool seems obvious, but we're forgetting the rules. I'm drowning.
It's the pool.
I didn't get the viewpoint, did I?
No, you didn't.
Fucking hell. The pool could not have been the scene of the murder. Ryoma was killed at nighttime. No swimming is allowed at nighttime, so a living person could not have gone in.
Yep, a dead body is fine because it's just an object. But if a living person entered the pool, I think I might cry.
Cry as loud as you want. I'll cry with you. We can spend the night together crying. And the morning after, I'll write goodbye on your mirror and lipstick before I quietly leave.
Only after you leave do I realize how much you really mean to me. Quit being so gloomy. This is the end of the Jets. Fuck the Patriots.
Anyway, we can conclude it's impossible for him to drown in the pool. Where was Ryoma killed if not pool? Is there other place where water can be stored? Where is it? Sink. The sink in Ryoma's lap. There were distinct scratch marks on it. Scratch marks on the sink? And I believe those scratches were caused by... I mean, just him drowning, right? Oh. Maybe? Yes. The handcuffs. They were scratched as well, correct?
Oh yeah. It sort of looked like they'd been scraped against something.
There's also the fact that the handcuffs were from Ryoma's lab. The marks on the sink came from the handcuffs in the same room. The size and the shape of the scratches are consistent with the handcuffs, I'm sure. How did those handcuffs get from the lab to the water tank? Because Ryoma was wearing them, right? Yes, though they were only visible for a brief moment when Ryoma appeared in the tank. Ryoma digivolved too. I am certain he was wearing the handcuffs at that time.
Skull Ryoma.
The handcuffs were left after the piranhas devoured Ryoma.
And try to force Ryoma to digivolve.
Yeah. So the culprit handcuffs Ryoma and drowned him in his lab sink.
Ryoma must have been pretty yummy. He chomped up his entire body, arms, legs, brain.
Stop saying disgusting things. I don't want to hear it.
That crunchy texture with the fatty parts is right. Then when they bite down, it gushes.
Stop! Please stop! But how did Culprit handcuff Ryoma? King is impossible to catch.
Going to try.
He could have used Shukuchi method to get away. Unless someone ambush him?
It's possible they knocked him out before handcuffing him. Though there's no way we can be sure now that he's not but bones.
I thought he was ambushed. I'm pretty sure the culprit got Ryoma by... Oops, don't pay attention to little old me. I'm just talking to myself.
When you talk to yourself, pretend you're eating and chew with your mouth closed. Otherwise, you get a mouthful of peanut butter squid. It's so disgusting, you'll laugh.
So we all agree Ryoma was drowned in the sink in his lab, right?
Was that a reference
to something? Probably. Okay. I don't know, she's a fucking nerd. That sink could have held enough water to do it, for sure.
Alright, I'm calling it. The crime scene is Ryoma's fucking research lab.
But how did the culprit carry his body to the gym from there? Isn't Ryoma's lab on the third floor of the academy? It's actually not far at all. Although perhaps it's more accurate to say, there's a shortcut. Was there a shortcut?
What shortcut did it use? He just yeeted him out the fucking window.
How do I... Oh, confirm.
The toughest mystery of all.
The shortcut is the window in Ryoma's lab.
The window? That's right. None of the windows in the school open. Except the one in Ryoma's lab. And on top of that, the window faced the pool. You could see the gym straight across.
Do you think the culprit dropped Ryoma's body into the pool area from the lab window? Then they could have thrown the body into the piranha tank through the gym window. How's that? Mission complete!
Your explanation contradicts some things we've discussed earlier. The gym window was too high to reach from the poolside, even if one used the ladder.
That's right, I apologize. I must go on a journey to reflect on this.
We keep hitting dead ends, since we don't know how the body was thrown into the gym.
Well, that didn't really give us any info about the crime.
Not necessarily. We learned a lot of important information. Now that I'm sure the scene of the crime was Ryoma's lab, the case is becoming clearer. To determine how the body got from the crime scene to where it was found, I have to figure out how to get from the third floor window to the gym. Alright then, I have to analyze the possible methods and find the most likely.
Well, then it's time for Psyche Taxi, of course.
What the fuck is this?
Psyche Taxi, of course. You gotta gather letter cubes.
Oh no. What is this, Hangman and Logic Dive combined?
Use the X button to accelerate, left stick to move left and right.
What the shit?
And pick up letter cubes and complete the question. And then you head towards the escort that has the correct answer. If it's the right answer, you get in the car, otherwise something bad happens.
What?
There'll be other cars on the road. If you hit those, you will take energy, focus energy damage. You can use R1 to concentrate and avoid them. All right, enjoy.
What?
Please respond at your earliest convenience. Let's go!
This is a No More Heroes minigame. What is this? Okay. Okay. I was like, Shuichi? You good?
Beep, beep!
Bro? Maybe I shouldn't have put all my trust in this bro.
The body was brought from where? I'm just spelling out a question?
Yep, waste of time.
How do I... What?
Thinking time!
What? Okay.
What's the answer?
Was brought from...
Which one?
Good!
Oh my god, what's happening?
Where the fuck?
Shuichi's like, hell yeah, babe! And everyone's like, Shuichi, what the fuck are you talking about?
Making out in the air.
Yeah.
She's just like, oh man, it's you and me on the road, Kaede. And I was like, Shuichi, Kaede's fucking Shuichi. That's a bad, that's in poor taste, man.
Come on over, baby.
Goto's like, oh, thank goodness, Kaede, tell her I miss
her. She in car?
Yeah,
great. Tell her to come here.
Tell her to come here, yeah.
Gonta.
Oh, you're on your way to pick up Rantaro? Oh, it's been a while. We have not seen him.
I did not notice the billboards.
What are the billboards?
It's what's her face? Angie.
Oh, are they always Angie?
I have never looked at the billboards in this game because I'm always focusing on the road.
Yeah, I guess you described the scene for me, I guess.
Yeah. Maybe it's like an ad for Atua. That's kind of funny.
The body was brought to the gym from where?
Thinking time.
Gym window. Yeah. Okay.
Good.
Two Kaedes.
Two Kaedes. And then, yeah, that's why the Angie billboards are there. She's like, Atua promises like
as many Kaedes as you want.
This is weird. Like, this is like a very strange like idea. Like that you have to like figure you're doing Jeopardy like first and like
it's not really Jeopardy, you're just kinda uncovering the question. Okay. I'm gonna be frank. I think this is a huge waste of time.
Yeah, this is not. I can't even boost or anything.
Accelerate.
Oh, how do I accelerate?
Or I think you're going full acceleration.
Yeah. Okay. Never mind.
It doesn't like this part. You're literally just running into things. Like that's it.
Yeah.
You're just collecting cubes.
Okay, that's how it works. Okay. Can I hit two? Yes, I can.
Like as much as I don't like Logic Dive, and also the questions are super easy in this, at least from what I remember. Maybe for you it might be.
Was that Monokuma? What was that?
Maybe.
Could I have hit that? Was that a collectible? There are collectibles in the minigames? That's insane.
Too bad.
How is it moved from the classroom window to the gym window?
Thinking time.
Cool. Oh,
never mind. I thought this was easy, but never mind.
From window to window? No, because there's stuff in the pool. That's why I was like, okay. Oh, you know what? That makes sense with the rope. Yeah, okay.
Good.
After you kill the Kaede.
She just drifts like in the air like, okay.
Got it.
I'm back. I've got it. Ryoma's body was moved directly from his lap to the
Shuichi
gym.
He left his post and just ran around the room in a circle. Directly? Don't tell me they threw the body from window to window. I mean, we're talking about a body. It's not like tossing a baseball, you know?
No, I don't believe he was thrown, but perhaps another way.
What do you mean another way? There's no other way to move it.
The culprit must have used some kind of equipment.
Huh? Equipment?
With this equipment, they can connect the two windows and move the body to the gym. Equipment to connect the windows. I believe it was found near the body. Rope. Oh, wait, what?
Maybe that... I think you missed it.
Oh,
it did. Somehow.
Okay.
Yeah, you clicked the ground below.
Oh,
it.
Okay.
The floor! The floor...
The rope found behind the gym stage could have been used to connect the windows. Oh, there was a mysterious mystery about that rope that only Atua can reveal.
What mysterious mystery?
During last night's preparations for the show, that rope was in the wing of the stage. But the next morning, the rope had been moved backstage for some reason. It's a mysterious mystery. Only Atua knows the answer.
So, during nighttime, someone used the rope and threw it into the gym window?
So they did use the rope. That's how they bridged the distance between both windows. Is the rope long enough to reach both windows?
It's definitely long.
65 feet. That's the rope I used for all those women to help cordon off a four square cord. They all really enjoyed.
Of all the activities you could think of, a four square cord?
Yeah. I was like, jump rope,
yeah,
a tire swing. Yeah. I was like, what other kids' activities are there?
According to the sign at the pool, the width of the pool is roughly 35 feet. And the distance from the edges of the pool to the windows is an additional 16 feet. Altogether, the sum total length from one window to the other is roughly 50 feet.
And pool is the only thing between research lab and gym windows.
You bet it's long enough. That's what she said. Like a big old cock!
Wait, who said that? Even if the rope was long enough, wouldn't it be pretty hard to tie them to the windows?
Both windows were too high to
yes,
reach.
Yes, tying them to the windows. Terutarubozu, to keep the rain away, so that the women can play the games
Kyo,
at the village.
Please, please.
So sorry.
Yes. It would be like tying a rope from one cliff to another.
Ah, yes. If the windows
what
were...
could you possibly be thinking of, Kyo?
Why, obviously, we did rope climbing, like rock climbing. There was a top of a rock climbing wall, about 6 feet high. It was very safe, and the woman loved it. If the windows were closer together, then they could toss the rope across. Ah, but they're not. What is... Okay, what, Kyo? What tossing rope? You know, like when you make a hula hoop out of rope, and you toss it between each other. It's very fun.
No, Gonta think it would work. Just need one more rope.
Yes. With another rope, you
sometimes,
can.
Sometimes you need one more rope when you're showing off a rope statue and you need to tie a bow on top with a rope.
Another rope? There's only one, though.
Oh, then it's impossible. Sorry.
No, I'm sure there was another rope, or at least something that could be used as rope.
Where are you? Oh.
Korela. The Taznet cable from Ryoma's lab could serve as a rope. How long is it?
About 50 feet or so, but how do they use it?
Okay, so... Well, actually, yeah, it's funny you say that. Funny. See, the thread consistency of a tennis cable...
is perfect.
Oh. First, culprit hang rope outside of one window, then culprit move to the other side and tie cable to other window.
I like to imagine everyone's like keying in and be like, okay, yeah, Gonta, like we practice the grammar. Yeah. And you're like, keep close. Keep talking. It's okay.
Then, after trying to each tying to each window, culprit tie rope and cable together. That helped culprit make one rope that reached both windows.
Wow, that's amazing, Gonta. You're so knowledgeable.
It's nothing. Gonta used ropes a lot when looking for bugs.
I know that feeling, Gonta.
Even if they did connect the windows with a rope, they can't carry a body on just that.
Well, actually...
You can carry much bodies when you're doing a zip line.
Eureka, I got it. Ooh, Kyo, let's talk after this. Thomas Edison once said that genius is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. But in my case, it's 100% inspiration.
We get it, just tell us already.
They handcuffed the body to the rope and slid it from one window to the other like Tarzan. The body would reach the gym window, but it wouldn't land in the piranha tank. Stop making some dumbass comments and keep your smelly breath in your dirty mouth. Tarzan?
But they also had to put the body in the piranha tank after they moved it, huh?
That is not feasible with just one rope. Maybe the rope wasn't the only equipment the culprit used. Not just the rope?
Well, anyway, it would have been pretty difficult to get that body in the piranha tank. They wouldn't just throw it. The trick was a super crucial part of the culprit's plan. The culprit must have carefully placed the body into the tank with their own hands. Was there really a way to do that?
Kokichi, are you hinting at something?
Huh? Hint? What hint? Don't confuse me with your talk of hinting hints.
You're confusing me. You're definitely onto something. It's true that the culprit needed to place the body directly into the piranha tank. If the body were to fall, the culprit would not have been able to retrieve it. They would have only one shot at it, no second chances. So obviously the culprit would have wanted to put the body in the tank carefully. Meaning they would have wanted to get as close to the window as possible. The problem is, how did they get near it? All that we know right now is that there was a rope that connected the windows. Somehow the culprit used that to move the body and were close to the window themselves. To make that work, they would have to use something else. But what would that be? What could they have done?
Alright, Shuichi. The stage is finally set.
What?
Listen up. Do a good job here, and I'll be able to put an end to this trial. It all starts with you. You be the opening act, and I'll be the main event. And then together, we're gonna save everyone.
Together?
You got this. After all, you are my sidekick. I believe in you. So I'm gonna leave the rest to you.
Yeah. Okay, I can do this. I will solve this mystery and show everyone the truth. This is the main event. Something was used with the rope to move the body between the windows. Think. Come on, think.
Show the question. What did the culprit fashion to move the body between the windows?
I have no clue, to be honest. It's... Does it start with that? R? E? O? A rope line? That's not what the... Rope. A rope. What? A ropey. A rope.
A ropey.
A ropey.
Cool kids wear karopey.
Rope way? That's a rope way. I don't know what a rope way is.
You don't know what a ropeway is?
I don't know. What is that?
I guess you'll find out from Kyo.
Yes, that's it. The culprit used something like a ropeway to move the body. A ropeway, huh? Are you sure about that?
And just, I don't know. Say what that is just for, I don't know. Why, you got drain damage or something?
Drain
You need some kind of vessel to use on a ropeway, and we don't have that.
No, there definitely was. The culprit used it to move the body along the rope.
You know, like a pathway, a ropeway.
Like literally a bridge?
Yeah.
Just made of ropes?
Well, you'll see.
Okay. What is this?
Mind mine.
What the fuck? There's another, okay. Another new game? The objective is to dig up the answer. Answer will be covered by peace, blah, blah, blah.
You ever played Destructo? You weren't a Neopets guy, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you were?
Yeah.
Oh, Destructo match.
Oh, I didn't play that one very often.
What? It's the best game. All right.
Sorry. If you do it right, you can remove the blah, blah, blah. Okay.
It's a little different than the Destructo match, but basically, whatever pieces you click,
yeah,
you know, you'll figure it out. It's not that hard.
Yeah, okay.
If there's one piece left, you can break it, but it's a penalty. It's not that hard. It's pretty easy.
Okay.
So, like, if you break a group of pieces, they all get destroyed.
Yeah, yeah, this is connected.
Okay, but then everything around it changes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you're trying to find Square, what is it? Square? What did they use to ride across the ropeway?
Am I supposed to clear the entire thing, or?
It depends on what you're looking for.
Yeah, that's what I'm like.
What is this object? It's the two probably, right? Yeah, there it is. Oh, I can't. Oh. Oof. Is that on it? Is that on it? Or do I have to unveil every single object?
No. Get that pink cube. Now click it.
Interesting. Okay. This wasn't bad.
See, this one's like actually like this one.
Yeah. It's the inner tube. The rubber inner tube we found floating in the pool. The inner tube. Remember the inner tube we found in the pool with the rope on one side? Maybe the rope was originally tied on both sides. The culprit made a ropeway by hanging the tube from the rope connecting the windows. And because the third floor is higher up, gravity would have pushed the inner tube along. The inner tube is made of sturdy rubber as well. It could have supported the two people. The culprit used the ropes of the inner tubes to construct a rudimentary ropeway. So a ropeway is what? Like just like...
Yeah, just like it's a connecting thing made of rope. A ropeway.
Okay. It just looks like they just suspended a tire. I didn't know there was a word for it. Like I was like, oh, yeah, you just suspend a tire onto the rope and slide it down. Like, interesting. Okay. And use it to move themselves and Ryoma's body from the lab to the gym. Ah, yes. It was a hit with the ladies in the village.
They had so much fun.
Once through the gym window, the culprit stood on the inner tube to move the body. Either that or the culprit placed their foot on the windowsill. That way, we would be more stable and let them handle the corpse more carefully. Finally, they removed the rope from the window frame and left the scene.
Well, when you put it like that, it certainly sounds possible.
But wow, a ropeway! The hell is that?
You say the culprit placed their foot on the windowsill. Isn't that against the school rules? It would count as entering the gym, would it not?
Last time we got asked that question, we decided it was okay. Sticking your body through the window is an automatic out, but standing on the sill is...
Wait, who asked you last time?
Huh?
It is quite possible that the culprit went to you to confirm the details of their plan.
Oh, shit!
Way to put your foot in your mouth.
His foot? Mononosuke just unhinged as John swallowed his entire leg!
Cut it out! I can't write this off as a joke if you two keep freaking out about it!
Yeah. Then your little slip-up is actually the truth.
Pops.
Uh-oh. Daddy's mad at you now.
Huh? Don't look at me. This is what you get for acting like a big shot all the time.
Stop. Do not bully Mononosuke.
Huh?
No more blaming each other. Everybody makes mistakes. I want us all to get along.
Pro CDs, the more you learn. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye.